Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to the fourth session on government schemes. In this session also, I'm going to cover the areas where major amendments have been made, both in government schemes as well as acts or laws which have been passed recently, or if any amendments have been made in those areas. Okay. Just like the last three sessions, this session is going to be very brief, short, but at the same time very useful. If you have not seen the previous three sessions on government schemes, major amendments and acts and laws passed recently, do that immediately. Let us start without wasting any time with the first question, which is related to Bharatmala scheme. A very basic question, you might feel that it's not important, but the amendment is important. Under the Bharatmala scheme, the NHAI, National Highway Authority of India, has decided to consider only those projects that require minimal what? Total project implementation cost, time taken to be completed, land acquisition, and freight movement. So, which of the following projects are recommended or given more consideration over others? Projects which have lower cost, projects which take less time, projects where land acquisition is minimal, and projects where freight movement is the least. The answer to this question is C, land acquisition. Let's understand and talk a little bit about Bharatmala. It is the second largest highway construction project since NHDP, under which 50,000 kilometer of highway roads were targeted. NHAI was constituted for the development, maintenance and management of national highways a long time back. And it is the nodal agency of Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, which looks after national highways in India. Okay. The reason for shifting priority, which earlier was freight movement, is the land compensation cost, which increased after the new act, and the right to fair compensation and transparency in land acquisition. So this is the major amendment which was made in 2013, after which land compensation costs have increased, and therefore if the land acquisition is the minimal, the land compensation cost is minimal, and therefore that project will be approved or will be recommended over others. Before the act, land acquisition cost made up only 10% of project cost, but now it has increased to 30 to 40%, and therefore land acquisition cost is given, or land acquisition is given, first priority. Second question is about rebate of state and central taxes and levies scheme. The scheme has been launched by Ministry of Textiles, has been replaced with a new scheme. What is the name of that new scheme? The name is rebate of state and central taxes and levies scheme. So rebate of state levies scheme has been replaced now with rebate of state and central taxes and levies scheme. It was initiated by Ministry of Textiles. The purpose is to provide rebate to people involved in apparel and also everything other than apparel textiles, which is called as made up. In 2019, the scheme is replaced by this. Remember the name, very important name. Launched on 7th March 2019, will remain in force till 31st March 2020. What is the purpose? To provide rebate to all state and central taxes and levies to enhance the competitiveness of apparel and made up exports from India. So whatever exports have been made in the apparel industry or made ups, which is everything other than apparels and textiles, you will get some kind of rebate in the state and central taxes and levies. What is the rebate? 6.05% maximum rate for apparels, and for made ups 8.2% rebate in the taxes that are being paid by state, paid to the state government or the central government. Okay, remember that. New schemes launched in final budget 2019-20, in July 2019-20. Study in India is a new scheme. Which program is under implementation to attract foreign students by branding India as an attractive education destination, declared in final budget 2019-20? The answer is B, Study in India. Ministry of HRD has launched Study in India. The purpose is to double India's market share of global education from 1% to 2%. Government hopes to attract how many students? 1.5 lakh to 2 lakh international students by 2022. Scholarships are being provided and fee waivership is also being provided, ranging from 25% to 100%. Okay. The admission portal is studyinindia.gov.in. Remember this. Questions based on portals were asked last year in the year 2018 in examination in RBI. Therefore, remember them. Okay. The next question is related to One Nation, One Ration Card, or normally called as One Nation, One Card also. One Nation, One Card. To allow portability of food security benefits, I have discussed this in the revision document of or the revision video of government schemes. So I will not be discussing the entire idea of this scheme. The government is going to implement One Nation, One Ration Card scheme in the whole country by what? The answer is A, 30th June 2020. Ministry of Consumer Affairs is going to implement One Nation, One Ration Card. The purpose is portability of food security benefits. That means if a migrant worker is coming from Bihar to, let's say, Delhi, and if he still wants subsidized rice and wheat from any ration shop in Delhi, he should be able to do that. The condition is his ration card should be linked to Aadhaar, number one, and he will be getting only rice and wheat subsidy, not on grains, because the state funds distribution of grains, whereas rice and wheat are distributed through by the exchequer, by the funded by the central government. Okay. Nothing else is important here. Let's come to the last question for today. Sabka Vishwas Legacy Dispute Resolution Scheme 2019. The purpose is simple. Dispute resolution of cases that are pending in goods and services taxes regime. Okay. The question is, scheme namely Sabka Vishwas scheme is launched in final budget. What is the main aim of the scheme, as I just revealed it to you? The options are A, to settle the unresolved issues pertaining to direct and indirect taxes. No, it covers only indirect taxes, that is GST. To settle unresolved issues pertaining to all post and pre GST regime. No, it covers only pre GST regime, whatever cases are unresolved. To settle unresolved issues pertaining to post GST regime. No, it covers only pre GST regime. So the answer is D. On 5th July, this scheme was launched. The aim is to settle unresolved issues and clear about 3.75 lakh crore, which is blocked in litigations from pre-GST regime. Okay, quick closure of litigations means better business for these companies. Okay, the scheme shall give relief from payment of tax dues to the extent of 40% to 70%, depending upon the amount of tax dues involved. Okay, so this is all about this particular session, wherein I discussed all the recent amendments, new schemes launched or introduced recently through these five questions. Three sessions have already been done. This is the fourth one, and the last one will be the fifth session. So stay tuned for that particular session. If you have not subscribed to the channel, do it immediately, and also press the bell icon, because in that case you will not be able to miss the videos that I keep posting related to the upcoming RBI and SEBI exam. All the very best. Take care.